Morning, students. Today we are here to another session on Garudan service. We are going to see a practicals as per your semester 5. Right now, today whom we have is IHM Chennai, third year students, semester 5, B batch students of the college, IHM Chennai. So, what we are going to do is we are going to invite a guest and we are going to take care of the preparation part. So good morning, welcome. Welcome to the restaurant, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you. Sir, so hope you're doing good, sir. So let me serve you a filter water. Thank you. So welcome to our restaurant, sir. Sir, we have a specially designed menu from our chef. So recently we refurbished this menu. Please, sir, go to the menu. So I'd like to suggest you some dessert for the day, sir, or antrami for the day. So we have a wonderful antrami. We have crepe souze, we have banana rum, we have peach flambe, we have pineapple flambe as well. So I suggest you to try out a crepe souze, the first in the dish. Chef the Vegan is very popular in making crepe souze. So try to take order for the crepe souze. Thank you, sir. Sir, would you like to join with him for the crepe souze?
Yes, sir. Because, I'll order with the gentleman on.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The guest has ordered for two portions of crepe souze. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to take the we are going to hand over the KOT to Chef the Vegan. Chef the Vegan will.
Thank you, sir. Okay.
For the crepe souze, the requirement for making crepe souze is, first one, what we need is butter. Then what we need is the pancakes. The pancake is partially prepared before the operation commence. Then we have the other ingredients. The other ingredients for the preparation, I mean for crepe souze, are we have caster sugar, we have lemon rind, we have orange rind, we have fresh orange juice, and to flambe this, we have brandy with us. So here we have a unique pan. This is called as a souze pan. The souze pan is the name has come from the lady who dined in. From there, the crepe souze dish has been invented. The lady name is souze, so this pan name is also souze.
Good morning, students. Today we are going to make your crepe souze. Here we are going to imitate the way of your sugar dredging method. Okay, so we don't have the apparatus here, but nonetheless we are going to use the sugar, and we are going to use specifically the caster sugar here. Okay, and you take the pan nearby, sprinkle it up, give an even fine coat. The sugar and the butter when you're gonna use should be of the equivalent quantity. Okay, right? So kindly see this. The final even coat has been added. So we're gonna keep the pan here. Whenever you're gonna use the pan, kindly make sure you use a cloth because it is quite hot. This is the old style pan. Okay, copper bottom. So here we're gonna wait for a little more moment for the sugar to caramelize. Within a fraction of a second, you can see the sugar melting up, giving out the liquid. Okay. Use a service fork and just move up. We're gonna work on the sugar. As I had told, this pan is copper bottomed. It actually picks up your heat very fast. Okay, so you need to know and control the temperature. You can take it up, take it away from the flame, do a little bit of just put it up here, bring all the sugar in the front so that it will be easier for you to work. Right? So you can just see now how the sugar has started to caramelize. Right? So this, we need to get it to a little bit brown color. Then we're going to start off with your recipe more. So you see the color coming out, it's coming a beautiful brown color. Brown golden color we're getting here, nice. This actually gives you more flavor to your dish. Okay, you should know what is the perfect color to get it. See, this is sugar work, so you need to keep on working on your hand with your pan. Okay, if you leave it, it will solidify. So now it is ready. We're gonna add your butter here. This comes out a beautiful caramelized color. Take it away from the flame, work out a little bit. We'll add a little more butter here. The sugar to the butter, when it comes, you'll get a beautiful sauce here, right? Work it up all the way to the front, right? So you don't want to do any wastage here. This is the reason we use a caster sugar, right? Because as soon as we add it along, it starts to work properly, evenly. We'll get a beautiful colored product here. Now, you have seen this. It's melted, it's thick, it's coating the fork here. That's really nice. Do keep it near the flame, get it up a little bit mixed up. So now it is good. So to this, we're going to add your orange juice. So take some orange juice, pour it up here, around 50 ml, 30 to 50 ml. Kindly control your heat, okay? See, the moment you leave, it sticks up. So you need to bring in the heat here again, work it up. It's coming into a beautiful brown color. Get it condensed, it will thicken a little bit more to a sauce consistency. So here, as per order, we are making the dish for two portions here, right? So let it cook. Let it melt. If you see you find any solidifications here, bring the sauce a little bit on this other side. Work it up, it will come out. No lumps, we don't want any lumps happening out here. Okay, it will come really nice color. So now to this, we're going to add few more items, your lemon and your orange peels. We will not add too much, okay guys. As I told, we have your essential oils in these peels. So this gives you the required bitterness for the dish, okay. So the essential oils actually has a little bit of vitamin C along with your on the skin, right? So this vitamin C, when you're gonna heat it up, cook it up, what's gonna happen? The acid is going to break and the bitterness is distributed. Clear? See, it's coming out good. It's coating out the back of the spoon. Beautifully coming. Can you see this? Yes. It's coating the spoon, it's coming a really good consistency. We'll just give it a little more heat. Let's keep on working on it. Okay, now we're gonna add the pancake here. Bring the pancake to your sauce. Okay, and then kindly start working on it. Let it macerate here a little bit. we need to assist in making the dish more prevalent. So we're gonna bask the dish with the sauce here, okay? Right? So now let us allow the pancake to cook a little bit. Let it absorb the juices. Now we're going to fold the pancake to a semi-crescent. Okay. Then again, we want to make it another fold. So it's come really good. So we, as per order, there are two pancakes here. So we had added the second one as well. We're going to make it cook. So here we are coating the second pancake as well with the sauce. Right? Can you find the golden color here coming? Yes. So let it cook a little bit. Let us allow it to cook a little bit, absorb the juices. The sauce is coming out really nice. Next tip here is we're going to add in the brandy. Okay, as per menu, as I told you, this is supposed to be coin through. But as per availability, we are using now brandy. Now the dish should be very hot. Okay, a fraction of a second, take it aside. Add the brandy, let it flame, come up really nice. So the flame is actually cooking the pancake a little bit more to give you more flavor, guys. Remember that. Very good blue flame, which means the dish has come out really nice. Okay. We don't need to disturb the flame, let it cook. Okay. It will subside by itself. So till then, let's wait. Yes, now the dish is done. We are going to plate the dish here. The pancake will be very delicate. Kindly make sure you don't break it. Lemon peels, the orange peels all give you beautiful taste here.
So now the prepared dish is ready. Crepes are up. We will take it and serve it to the guest. Sir, your crepes is a piece. Enjoy your lunch.
Thank you.
Wonderfully prepared by our chef, Chef Vegan. Please enjoy your review, sir. Thank you, sir. So hope we'll take some feedback from the guests as well about the crepe or what Chef Vegan has made today.
It was a good showmanship. I really enjoyed the experience. Thank you to all the students and this wonderful sir who did this for us. It has been a good learning for all of us, and I hope to learn more in the coming classes. It tasted really nice. It was really sweet, and there was a hint of bitterness as well. And the zest and the peels did a really good job at elevating the flavors and the aroma. Really liked it.
Sir, how was the dessert?
I was fascinated by the flambé that the chef did, and also I really enjoyed the bitterness and the tangerine flavor of the oranges and the lemon. It had a really good texture, and it taste. The aftertaste of it was really good in my mouth, so I enjoyed it a lot.
Thank you so much, sir. So, students, we had a lot of preparation for the crepe suzette, the first invented dish, crepe suzette. So, in the next practicals, we are going to do few more entremets, and we're going to see some proof course and a coffee course. So we will be doing an omelet or rum in a proof course. Peach flambe, pineapple flambe, and parna rum in entremet. And then we'll be doing Irish coffee in coffee course. So we'll be learning all these things in the next class.
Made this practicals very interesting. Have a nice day.
Thank you.